In this Cornelius Composer tutorial, we're going to be looking at selection tools. By default, Cornelius Composer is in selection mode, which you can see highlighted in the bottom left corner of the screen. It is the middle of the three green buttons. While in this mode, the program behaves just as you would expect. Pressing any notes or rests on the sheet will select them one at a time, and clicking other sheet elements will open their options for editing. And, as we saw in the first tutorial video, pretty much everything you see on the sheet is clickable and editable. When selecting notes or rests, the measures that they belong to will also be implicitly selected. An orange highlight represents selected notes, and a yellow highlight represents selected measures. Selecting any note or rest will also place the cursor on the sheet at that note's position. This cursor determines where playback is going to start when you listen to your composition, and it also has an effect on some selection operations. The cursor is represented by a red vertical line that appears behind the notes. You can select an entire measure and the notes that it contains by pressing on an empty space that is contained within the measure. If you're on a device with a mouse, this is represented by a yellow outline around the measure. Pressing the beam that is connecting a group of notes will select that entire group. An alternative way that you can select notes or rests is by pressing the left and right arrow keys on your keyboard. If you hold down the Shift key while doing so, it will extend the selection instead. After making a selection, the context menu library becomes available, and this can be opened by pressing the yellow button to the left of the figure library, near the bottom left corner of the screen. Or, if you're on a device with a mouse, you can right-click to access the exact same options. The context menu and its options will be covered in further detail in another video. Next up is the Selection Plus tool. It is the leftmost of the three green buttons. While in this mode, you can select multiple notes or rests without removing your previous selection. You can select as many as you want at the same time. While in Selection Plus mode, pressing a note that is already selected will deselect it. You can also activate this mode by pressing and holding the Control key on a Windows computer or the Command key on a Mac. If you hold down the Shift key instead, it will select everything between the position of the sheet's cursor and the note or rest that you pressed. With a group of notes selected, you can press and drag on one of them to change the pitch of the entire selection. You can also use the up and down arrow keys on your keyboard to achieve the same effect. Pressing the delete or the backspace key will convert any notes in the selection into rests. Dots, accidentals, and tizer slurs can also be selected, and you can even select multiple at the same time by using the Selection Plus tool. But there is a small caveat. You cannot select these symbols and notes or rests at the same time. If you have any notes selected and you try to add dots, accidentals, or ties and slurs to your selection, it won't have any effect. Just as with notes, you can delete any selected symbols by pressing the delete or the backspace key. And lastly, we have the eraser tool. While in this mode, pressing any notes or symbols will delete them. You can also delete a group of notes by pressing the beam that is connecting them. And if you press on an empty space that belongs to a measure, once again represented by the yellow outline around the measure, you will delete that entire measure. That's all for this Cornelius Composer tutorial. Thank you for watching, and let's make music!